We all learned as we were growing up that we should brush our teeth after every meal and see the dentist twice a year, not twice a decade, twice a year. But what else should we know? Dentist Steve Marsh is here to open wide what we don't know about our dental care. Steve, thanks for joining us today.
It's my pleasure, Armin.
You know, we're not dentists. You know, we don't keep up with all the latest stuff. You do. Is it a problem that that people generally don't?
Yeah, and in fact, one of the greatest things about Golden Opportunities, it's given us an opportunity to expose the viewers in the viewing area to what's going on in dentistry. Recently, like you give talks in the community, I gave one actually at Fairmount Temple Brotherhood. And afterwards, people came up to me one after another, one by one, to say, what about this, what about that? And despite the fact that I had given a 45-minute or hour presentation, there were still a lot of questions. So
always.
I thought, let's bring some of them to the viewers. One of the biggest questions we hear about today is, what about x-rays?
Mm-hmm.
Are they necessary? That's the only way a dentist can see between the teeth, which is the most common place for decay to occur. So then the question was, what are they safe? What do we do? One of the important things is a thyroid collar, Armin. This is a lead apron.
That's this big thing. It's heavy.
And the lead apron, every dentist uses it and should be using it. But what's very important today is this piece up in here. This is called the thyroid collar. Put it on you here a little, and that protects the thyroid.
Very stylish, too.
And just so you know, yeah, we're not looking for style here, but safety. Just so you know, x-rays today are very safe dental x-rays. It's like being in the sun for 2 to 3 minutes. So they work very well, and today with digital x-rays, there's 90% less radiation than we used to have. So they're important at least once a year. We think it's the dentist's prerogative to look at that so we can be effective.
And you brought some other gizmos here. Can you show us what you got?
Yeah, this is, we talk about cavity detection. So how does a dentist know? One is x-rays. I'm going to try and hold this up. This is the sort of quintessential dental instrument, the Dental Explorer.
Mm-hmm.
And the Dental Explorer works by, when the dentist looks at your teeth, we put the point in the tooth, and if it sinks in a little, it tells us that there's decay, there's a softening. So that's what we used to use.
Okay.
Today there's some very modern techniques. This is called the Diagnodent, and it's actually a laser. And what happens is, Armin, you'll see a little laser light, and we actually place that on the tooth, and that light will indicate whether or not there's decay. What happens is it measures the density, it gives us a reading, and that's another way we can tell whether or not there's decay.
All right.
The third way, sometimes a dentist will look at your tooth and you feel him scratching. What's he looking for? We're looking for a softness in the tooth. Well, sometimes you can't always detect it. Is it stained or is it a defect? Today, we use this dye. And when I clean out a tooth, Armand, I actually put this dye on the tooth and we place it on it and then we wash it off. If there's dye remaining, it tells us there's still decay. So a dentist today can use that to help detect and make sure that when we're cleaning out a cavity, it's all cleaned out. You know, decay is like rust on a car. You have to get it all out. And lastly, what's really important today is a dentist wears magnification. These are my magnifying loops. They're now 4 times the strength that a normal eye can see. Not that attractive, but it makes us
like
more...
Like Roger Rabbit with the eyes.
And much more effective. Now, my dad was a dentist, as we've talked about before, 50 years ago. He used magnification, but things have changed a lot. And I think dentists today, and fortunately, almost all dentists today do use magnification.
And very quickly, cavities, replacing cavities, replacing fillings, some new things?
New things. And one of the great techniques in dentistry is using tooth color restorations. Recently, I had a patient came in, and you can see that old silver filling was breaking down. We used composite. Again, we used the cavity detection systems to be able to do that.
Okay.
Here's somebody who, after a number of years, his teeth had worn out. They had moved forward. Today, one of the big techniques is porcelain veneers, and we used some porcelain veneers, brought those teeth in, and gave them a beautiful smile.
All right. Steve, always great information. Thank you very much.
And listen, thank you for allowing me to bring this to the viewers and the Cleveland community. It's really been gratifying for me.
Great. Heard something new? Ask your dentist about it or give Steve Marsh a call. His number's up next.
See what Dr. Stephen Marsh can do for your smile by calling 440-461-1003 or visit www.clevelandsmiles.com. Next, all aboard for Easy Adventures.